Hey there, my name is Aaron Morin and I'm the lead educator here at Thinkific. Today, I'm going to show you how you can use Thinkific's online course platform to grow your business with education, just like tens of thousands of independent experts, creators, entrepreneurs, authors, speakers, trainers, coaches, nonprofits, technology companies, small and big businesses, and educators already do. Woo! With Thinkific, you can build your own training website where you can create, market, sell, and deliver online courses to your audience. Thinkific's suite of tools is designed at every step to help you deliver tangible results to your students so that you can create a sustainable business. If they succeed, you succeed. Now, before we begin, keep in mind that you can speed up or slow down the video, skip around on the play bar, and read closed captions here. If you have questions about Thinkific as we go, please don't hesitate to reach out to support@thinkific.com. We'd love to chat. Okay, let's get started with a good example. This is an example of a Thinkific website starting at the homepage. Keep in mind, you can completely customize your Thinkific website to match your own branding. You've got total control here. From here, we can learn more about the course website, navigate via links back to an external website or other pages, and click on buttons and cards that will take me further down the sales funnel. Here's a course landing page, sales page, squeeze page, or whatever you'd like to call it. The purpose of this page is to convince your visitor to buy the course. When the lead is ready to begin purchasing, you can link them to a checkout right on your Thinkific website, or an external checkout if you'd like. They'll need to sign up once for a student account that they can use to enroll in any courses you enable them to, and to track their own progress and purchases. In this on-site checkout powered by Stripe or PayPal, the course is paid for and the student is sent along to a thank you page. The process was simple here, but remember, this whole path is customizable. When students start a Thinkific online course, they enter the course player, a distraction-free learning zone complete with everything you need to create rich student experiences. Students can watch, read, listen to, download, if you wish, and interact with your course content. Students who progress through lessons will have their progress tracked individually, and they can review the work they've done so far in their Achievements and Progress tab. You can even include a discussion forum for students to communicate with you and each other about the course. There's even a handy search bar for lessons, and your students can leave reviews that you can add to your sales pages later. Students can track their own progress and get back to lessons easily from their own student dashboard. And they can change their profile details, like their password, access any certifications they've earned, manage their credit card info, and see past orders to get receipts, all on their own. Pretty great, right? Now, let's take a peek behind the curtain and explore what a course creator can do with Thinkific. When you sign up for a Thinkific website, you'll find a few things to do right away, like create a new course, get started building a website, or attending our next training sessions or webinars. You can get started however you want, but in this video, we'll start with how quick and easy it is to create an online course with Thinkific. Let's head over to Courses to get started. We need to make a new course, and when we do that, we'll be able to create one using a course template. We put these together to take the guesswork out of instructional design. You don't have to use one, but if you do, it'll include a curriculum skeleton and some helpful starter content and instructions. For now, I'll just use the blank template. Now let's name this course something really original. Don't worry, you can change anything after creating, saving, or publishing in Thinkific because, you know, we all make mistakes and bad jokes, right? You'll notice we've entered a different part of the Thinkific backend here. This is the course builder, and you can use it to design and develop your online courses before publishing them. We're in the curriculum tab right now, but we'll come back here later. For now, let's make things quick and easy. I'm going to bulk import my course content that's already ready to go. Let's see here, where did I put it all? Ah, I've got a video, a PDF, and an audio file. I'll drag and drop them right into the bulk importer. And just like that, Thinkific has processed these files into lessons for chapter 1 of my online course. Let's add another chapter and drop in more content. Each of these chapters contains as many lessons as you need, and you can change the order of the lessons or chapters by dragging and dropping them. Piece of cake. Let's head back to the curriculum tab. You can see that when I click on one of these lessons, I have some more options for the lesson. I can make this lesson a part of a free trial for my course, unpublish it by setting it to draft, or make it downloadable or autoplay in the course player. I can also make a prerequisite lesson, which means students will need to complete it before moving on to the next chapter of lessons. Most of these options exist for each lesson type in Thinkific. As you can see, video, PDF, and audio lessons aren't the only ways to teach. You can teach your students with video, audio, text, PDFs, narrated slideshows, and multimedia. You can also engage students with quizzes, exams, surveys, discussions, and downloads. All right, so let's add a quick pop quiz to help reinforce my students' learning. Then I'll add a question, an easy one that helps a student reinforce their learning, and then add a few multiple choice answers. I can add an explanation at the end here, but you know why this answer's right, right? I could also make this quiz graded. Or if I had a bunch of questions, import them all and only have the quiz show a few questions from a question bank each time it loads so that each assessment is unique. We've already discussed prerequisites, but there's another way to pace out your content in Thinkific. You'll find you can set up a release schedule for your lessons based on either the student's enrollment date or the course launch date. Drip schedules are a great way to make sure that your cohort of students are working at the same pace, to run a time-based challenge, or to space out all your content so it isn't so overwhelming to the student. Under settings, you can find all the options Thinkific gives you to customize how students engage with your course. You can control enrollments with private courses, hide courses from public visitors to your course site, offer completion certificates to incentivize and reward 100% course completions, and much more. I'll let you explore more of this toolbox on your own. The only thing we have to do now that we're done with our curriculum, is price our course. You can always leave your courses to be free, which is a great way to help you build your email list, by the way. But when you integrate with a supported payment processor like Stripe or PayPal, you can price your course a number of ways. And with our Stripe integration, you can set your course site to charge in most currencies as well. First, one-time fees can be set to charge your students once for the course. You can optionally limit the enrollment period as well. I'll price this course at $100 for 3 months of access, for example. Now, I can also set a subscription price for recurring charges for continued access to the course contents. You can include a free trial period and a custom first-time payment by which you can charge an upfront fee and a regular rate afterwards. Or I can set up a payment plan, which is like a subscription price, but it will stop charging my customer after a specific number of payments. And I can even have all three payment methods for my course available at once and all displayed on my sales pages. Finishing up here, I'll need to publish my course if I want anyone to be able to enroll in it, so let's do that next. If you want, you can preview how your course looks from here, or you can continue on to building your course landing page. Before we get any farther, you should know that your Thinkific website is made up of individual pages. There's a few standard pages like your home page and your course sales page, and you can make new ones too. You can completely customize your website's design and content on every page using the site builder here. I'm editing our course's sales page here, but if I wanted to edit other sales pages, I just need to back up here to find them. Moving once more back, I can see our home page and find any other pages, including custom pages, and edit them. The theme settings tab here will give you options to change the look of your course site, including the colors, fonts, the favicon, and more. You can even fast track your designs with these style presets. Remember to save or discard changes you make to confirm them or revert them. The preview here will update when you make changes automatically, but you can opt out of that if you wish. Now you might be wondering what a theme is at this point, and that's totally understandable. But I can't tell you because it's a secret. Okay, fine, I'll tell you. If you exit the site builder, you're taken to the theme library, where you can get back to site builder and explore other Thinkific themes. Themes help you design a website quickly, and each have their own personality. They've all been designed for education businesses, so you can't really go wrong, but you should decide on a theme to stick with before editing your pages. You'll have a default theme here, or the theme you selected when you signed up for Thinkific, but you can explore others and their presets in the theme library. Publishing a theme makes it live. You can build out your website in a particular unpublished theme beforehand to avoid looking like you're under construction too. Okay, let's jump back into Site Builder for our active theme and get started. All right, we're back to the course landing page, the sales page that will convince my leads to buy and enroll in my online course. Your header and footer stays the same across all of your pages, but you can make everything in between unique to the page. These sections here make up the content on this page. We can easily rearrange them by dragging and dropping. We can add a new section here and edit sections by clicking into it. Some sections contain blocks, and these blocks can be rearranged by dragging and dropping as well. And some page sections are smart sections, which means they'll automatically update when I change details elsewhere on my course site. For example, if I added more lessons to my course, I wouldn't need to come back here and then add them in this curriculum section. It just does it automatically. Fancy, hey? Now, naturally, we want to get students to start enrolling in our course. So let's look at some of the best features Thinkific has to help you do that. First, we have a few courses already made here, so we can start to offer a package of included courses called a bundle. Bundles are a great way to enroll a student in multiple courses from just one transaction. Bundles get their own landing pages and checkouts just like courses do. You can use them to turn your individual online courses into an all-access membership deal, for example. As well, promotional pricing is a great way to sell more courses, especially when you're launching your new Thinkific course site. Coupons allow you to set up codes that buyers can use at the checkout to get a sale price or a special deal, like the first month half off for my membership bundle, for example. We're not always looking for new customers. We want to upsell to our existing customers or maybe re-engage lost prospects as well. On the users page, you can segment your students to find opportunities for promotional outreach. For example, if I filter my users to show me all of my free trial leads that haven't purchased yet, I can send them all an email right from my Thinkific website. In this email, I'll include some targeted messaging and a coupon code to help change their minds about buying my course. I can even include a link directly to the checkout with that coupon code already applied. Now that's thinking with coupons. You can apply all kinds of filters to this table in order to gather other insights from your users as well. Then you can bookmark them for later use. And students aren't the only user types in Thinkific. You can create new users for each member of your team. You can even run your own affiliate network right from your Thinkific website. If you're sharing revenue with other instructors, share a percentage of the revenue from individual courses or bundles that they've contributed to. Course admins help you manage your courses without getting into all of the site settings, for example. Now, we know you need total control over your course site if it's going to be crucial for your online business. So we've made some powerful features to help you make your Thinkific website your own. For example, you can add your own logo, brand colors, and fonts. And you can link anywhere to your existing website, like in your site header or maybe your logo. And you can link your Thinkific course site to your own existing website by adding a custom domain, or you can use your Thinkific website as your main web property. Even your video content uploaded to Thinkific can also be branded. In the video library, you can easily manage your videos and brand your video player. You can add captions to videos, custom thumbnails, and gather insights from video viewing to help you make better content in the future. And on top of all of that, we integrate directly with industry-leading marketing, analytics, and e-commerce services so that you don't have to ditch the tools you already love. Now don't worry, that excitement you're feeling right now, that's totally normal. This is a lot to take in, I get it, but there's even more to a Thinkific course site than I've shown you here. So, if you want to explore everything I've shown you and more, start for free by registering for your own online course website at thinkific.com.